bench congratulating Jackson Nika on a
minor penalty.
Great effort. And you see the pats on the back all around. Mike Yo. Here's Jackson Nika. Look at Tays. He's one. Let's make sure it gets over the goal line. But Stanika goes right by him. And then Tays, with Stanika in control, reaches in one hand, reading the hands of Jack Stanika, and the hooking penalty is called.
Canucks 0 for 4 on the power play. Another opportunity to break through and get within a goal. Hughes. Pass to Pettersson, took it off his skate. Besser's in front. As Pettersson lets go with a shot, Besser could tip it. And Georgiev, the glove save, hangs on to stop play.
Well, and you can see Elias Pettersson kind of shaking his head. I think he was hoping that Besser would stay for the screen and not go for the tip.
Jumped out of the way.
Jumped out of the way looking for the tip.
Absent. Helm out for the face-off to the left of their goal. And he wins it. Makar shoots the puck around and down the ice. Hughes cuts in front of his own net, skates out. Now feeds Horvat, who's in the speed. Stays out. Hughes put himself offside with that pass to JT Miller, and now the second unit will come on with 58 seconds to go on the penalty to Devon Taves.
A couple of long wrist shots. That time, Brock Besser stayed in front for the screen. Georgiev, because of his positioning, took it off the chest. That's something to happen with man advantage to get this many power plays. Still in the second period, 7 minutes left here in the second period. This is power play number 5.
It's the most they've had in a while. Go back to early December when they had 8 against Arizona. Whoa, that hit the referee. They should stop play here. He's going to stay in the game. Set it up. Who's Knight on the back end? Scores! Well, kudos to referee Michael Markovic, who got stung by that puck, but Gamely stayed in the game. And the Canucks on the power play get a goal from Kuzmenko to get within one.
Do you think the Avalanche will like it? Because that one would have gone all the way out. And so the referee does the Canuck a favor, not unintentionally, obviously, and gets hit high, and you can see the Avalanche get this one and just fire it. And it's the referee, and so it stays in. And what quick hands. Andrei Kuzmenko fakes a pass, forehand backhand, and just shovels it by Georgiev. Fakes pass, forehand, backhand, underneath the arm. What quick hands by Andrei Kuzmenko.
And now there's another penalty. Cogliano's in the box. I don't know if something was said from the bench. Maybe Jared Bednar. And it probably is something that was said to the officials following the goal. And the Canucks may be right back on the power play for the 6th time, having just scored, to go 1 for 5 and get within a goal.
You think it was get out of the way?
Something like that.
Yes.
full strength, so it's probably just a misconduct. Just a misconduct. Cogliano himself must have said
something.
So it's not a power. of 28. Comfer against Horvat. Puck to the side. Ekman Larson. Held on to by Lekkonen. Now feeds the puck back to Myers. Fell down, but able to hook it to Miller. And he gets the puck out. Gloved down by Kale McCarr, who's shadowed by Elias Pettersson. McCarr to Rantanen. 2 minutes remaining. Rantanen carries ahead. Dishes off. Lekkonen attacking from the side. He shoots. Stick save by Delia. Lekkonen gets the puck. Myers moves to check in. Comfer digs it free. Runs into Bo Horvat. Horvat plays the puck around for Ekman Larson. He gets it ahead. Pettersson has it. He's got Miller with him. Elias Pettersson. G.T. Miller. Empty net. Scores. G.T. Miller from Elias Pettersson. And the Canucks with a minute 36 to go. Lead 4-2.
And Oliver Ekman Larson.
Comes at 18-24. Goals have been hard to come by of late for Miller. He's got one now, though. His third in 17 games, and it's a big one, taking some of the pressure off. But it's not all off. There's still time left here. There goes Georgiev towards the bench again, not all the way. He's waiting for the signal, and now he gets it from Jared Bednar. Six attackers again for Colorado. Minute 10 to go. Pass back. Lekkonen. McKinnon shoots. Blocked. Myers got in front of it. Garland gonna launch one towards the empty goal. He'll miss. It'll be icing with exactly 1 minute remaining in the third period. Fanuary's back at Play Now Sports. You can win exclusive Vancouver Canucks prizes and experiences every time the Canucks play during the month of January. Check out playnow.com/Fanuary for details. Must be 19 plus to play.
They'll be talking about block shots in the postgame. There was another one by Tyler Myers. It set up and perfect block shot by Tyler Myers.
Colorado's called timeout with a minute to go. Odds are against them, but you don't become Stanley Cup champions without pulling some rabbits out of hats.
Mike Yeo. Talking to his defensive line that's going to be out there. Give Bruce Boudreau and his coaching staff credit. They matched up the Lazar line and against McKinnon and Rantanen for most of the game. And it's worked out pretty well.
Timeout done. And the faceoff upcoming to the right of Colin Delia. Six attackers for Colorado. Newhook will take the draw against Lazar, who's out there with Garland and McKay. Of course, the Canucks couldn't change. Puck escapes. Garland digging for it. Comes free. And at the blue line, McCarr takes possession. Near side, Rantanen. Wrist shot. Delia the save with the left pad. McKinnon gets it on his puck, gets the line. McCarr keeps it in. Watched by Lazar. Here's McKinnon back to McCarr. Now Rantanen, top of the circle. Wrist shot, knocked down by Delia. Rebound, shanned wide by Lekkonen. 35 seconds left. McKinnon, wrist shot, that bounced wide to the goal. 30 seconds to go. Rantanen. Down low, gets a return pass. Mikko Rantanen lost the handle for a moment, gets it back. 20 seconds left. Rantanen to McCarr, lets one go, and that was blocked. McKinnon lost the puck. Garland tried to get it ahead for McKay. That was broken up. 10 seconds left. starts in a while.
You're right, Ed. And you and I get to pick stars. Colin Delia there again. No rebound. Boy, he has been confident in this game. He's handled the puck really well, been steady, he's been between the posts, and he's controlled the rebounds. He's been good.
They'll drop the puck to his right. New hook went forward with it. Myers takes control, and that will do it. The Canucks' three-game losing streak is done. Brock Besser gets what proves to be the winner. Colin Delia stopped 29 of 31. Two goals for Andre Kuzmenko. And the Canucks send the Colorado Avalanche to a fifth straight defeat as they win it 4-2 at home.